One spark is enough to reignite a revolution. The Bone Shaker, our train, travels the rail connecting our two worlds. The last surviving remains of the pyre drives the heart of our engine. The gilded wing will stop at nothing to destroy it. But the champions of hell will defend what's ours. Because if we don't, there will be nothing left to defend.
Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome to your first impressions of Monster Train. This game was developed by Shiny Shoe and also published by Good Shepherd Entertainment. And as a really quick disclaimer before we hop on and getting to know the game, this key was given to me by the developer. So thank you very much to Shiny Shoe as well as Good Shepherd Entertainment for providing this key. This is not a sponsored video. However, I have been under embargo, but the embargo is now lifted. So let's get to it. What is Monster Train? Monster Train is essentially a good take on a little bit of mix between, you'll see the aesthetic of a little bit of Hearthstone and Warcrafty kind of vibes here, but most importantly, the gameplay is based off of something more akin to Slay the Spire. Is a deck builder roguelite that features like waves of enemies that you have to basically defend your core, or in this case, the engine of the Monster Train, as you saw in the intro there, the pyre, from enemies attacking it. And by way of doing that, you put your units in front of the enemies. They combat. If they get past there, they go one floor up and up and up. It's very, very, it looks like a lot of systems in play, but once you see everything in motion, it's a very, very interesting and engaging game. And I think that a lot of you, for those of you who are fans of deck builders and fans of roguelites, and especially stuff like Slay the Spire, you will absolutely love this game. This game comes out on May 21st. You can actually play the demo right now on Steam. I do not know if it's going to be free to play or if it's going to be pay to play, like just a regular standard retail release. I do not have the information at the time of this recording. Also, keep in mind that this video was taken as the game is a work in progress, so what you see in this video may not represent the final product as the game is developed. For that, let's hop onto it. Single player, there is multiplayer. I have not done anything in multiplayer yet. I've only done one completed run just to learn the game, and let's go into a brand new run here. So we'll see how well we can actually go, how far we can get. I've gotten to the fourth level, and that was it. So at the beginning here, you get to choose your primary clan. I can only have two right now. I could also go random, but you have the Hellhorn, really aggressive demons from the Scorched Plains, overwhelm Seraph with imps and damaging warriors. Or we could go the Awoken. Gather the Awoken of the Wild Forest. Hollows and Animuses are supported by healing channelers. So I have the first run I did, I was Hellhorn. This time around, I'm going to go Awakened. I'm going to go for the Awoken, and so this means that we're going to primarily get cards based on the Awoken clan, and then our secondary cards are mostly going to be allied clan stuff, and that sounds good. I don't have any wins yet, and I have a zero win streak because, well, as you can see here, I've only done one run. Let's go. So here's the meat and potatoes of the game. The final boss is Seraph the Diligent. The end is near. The great traitor would devour your... Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. We probably won't get all the way there. Welcome to Limbo. This is where we start off our journey. So this is our train. Essentially, this is where this rail here will provide us with our branching paths and choices that we can make across the game. And we can really choose our own path and adventure. Dark Forge, upgrade your champion, and Herzal's Horde to gain an artifact. We get both of these since they're on either side. What can I do for you? Let's see. We got 10 spikes. So when a unit with spikes is attacked, the attacker takes 1 damage per stack. So if they attack this wall, essentially they take 10 damage per. Or rejuvenate, deal 10 damage to a front unit. Triggers when healed, even at full health. Wow. So if we get a bunch of basic cards, we can just spam heal on this and deal 10 damage to the enemy. That seems pretty good. Let's augment our sentience with explosive. I like the sound of that. All right, Herzal's Horde. So artifacts are essentially what you would associate with relics in Slay the Spire. So these are going to be passive abilities that we gain as we go through our story mode and our run. Scorched Steel. Friendly units enter with 5 armor. That's pretty good. Boon of the Blacksmith. Our pyre gets plus 15 attack. Ooh, so this is our pyre health up here. As you see here, our pyre currently starts off at the default level with 80 HP and has 20 attack power. Scorched Steel is nice, but honestly, my pyre in the very first run was getting destroyed, so I would love to go for... Yeah, I'd love to go for this. Let's begin. Our first battle. All right, the Gathered Clergy. Angry hordes are swarming your train. Thin their numbers before they reach your pyre. So these trials here, these are additional combat modifiers and handicaps that we can choose if we so wish to kind of turn up the pressure on our deck. If we complete this round or this fight with this trial active, we will gain an additional reward of 75 coins. Non-enemy boss units enter with 3 spikes. So do we want to take 3 damage every time we attack an enemy, or is it not worth it? I'm going to say it's not worth it right now, especially since this is our first run. And you can see what happens whenever the Gathered Clergy gets there. We can also see what type of units it's going to be bringing in here. So let's keep the trial off and let's keep going. All right, so here we go. We have 4 enemy units going up against us. Now I'm going to explain the UI really quickly because this game moves very fast. Although I will slow down the combat just so you all can kind of figure out what's going on. Okay, so this is your train. You have at the start, I don't know if you can get additional floors. I don't think you can, but you have 3 floors before your pyre is vulnerable. So what will happen is your object is to destroy the enemy units before they reach your pyre and take it down for good. Now, as you see here on these stats, the pyre can actually attack, it can counterattack, can retaliate, and the combat is done sequentially. So the combat usually resolves it on its own. However, myself as the player, I can greatly affect what goes on here. As you can see here with Torch, I can throw out 2 damage here. This is their combat strength, so basically they'll deal 5 damage. This is their HP, and this is their special effect, which is Rage, and it gives them extra attacks, I think. Or yeah, plus 4 attack now, but it's plus 2 every stack of Rage, put it that way. So, anyway, how do we deal with this? Well, as you see here, the floor capacity, these little notches, we have currently 5. If you look at our only unit that we drew, which was the Sentient, it has 2 notches up at the top, meaning that if I were to place it here, as you see here, it's going to take 2 of our floor capacity, which of course is what I'm going to do. Now, because we augmented our Sentience with the explosion, the Rejuvenate, if I were to heal her once, she's going to wipe out everything on this floor, obviously, because it's going to deal 10 damage to everything. You can see what's going to happen by way of these little combat previews here. So we know that she's going to take lethal damage unless if we do something about these, which is exactly what we're going to do. Watch this. There we go. We have 2 more turns left. These Ember here, basically think of this as mana. This is how many times that this is our card cost. This is what our card cost basically subtracts from. So as you see here, this is a 1 cost, 1 cost, 1 cost. These are all lethal damage regardless of what we do. So all we have to do is really just remove them. There we go. And now we've made sure that our Sentient is not going to die. However, because we did not kill this one, what's going to happen now is that this clergyman is going to get some damage. He's going to inflict 5 damage on our Sentient and then move up a floor. So even though we didn't kill him, he still has to go through 2 more floors of whatever we throw in front of him to stop him from getting to the pyre. Now we have a fresh round of clergymen. And we also get a collector. So these collectors are random, and they're basically like loot goblins in a way. If you can stop them, go for it. We can put a train steward here to get the gold, or we could just kill it with a torch. I'd rather do that with a torch here, to be honest. There we go. So give me that 50 gold. We can ignore this one for now, or just try to kill him. I think it's more important that we try to keep the Sentient alive, however, and let's thin their ranks down here a little bit. So we'll put the train steward down here. We know that this one's going to die, but she won't anymore. And then we can also put a train steward over here, or we can put 2 in front of here. Actually, no, we can't, because if you see here, the floor capacity disallows us from doing that. So we have to put one up here if we wanted to put up another unit. Or I could heal her, and we could remove one of them from the board. I think I'm actually going to do that. That just makes more sense to me. And now we just have to resolve a turn. So judging by this indicator, this means that we're going to lose the train steward, and we're not going to basically kill anything. A brief respite, which means that we don't have to worry about any other enemies coming here, but the next round will give us the boss, so we have to take care of everything right now, otherwise it's not game over, but we're going to take a lot of damage on our pyre. We don't want that to happen. Take that one out. Take that one out. Even if we were to put a train steward here, he would still die because both of them will attack before we get to do anything here. So I think the best option now is just to restore. We could restore health on the sentient. And yeah, let's restore health. There we go. So these two are almost at the top. And there's the clergyman. This is the relentless wave. So combat in this room continues until all enemies are defeated. This unit cannot be rooted. Add self-mutilation to the top card of my draw pile. I don't know what that means. So we need to get rid of them. Now he only has 40 HP. And if we can take him down to 30 thanks to the restore explosion. I think what we want to do is we just want to spam heals on the sentient. We just need to get him down to 35. He's going to hit our pyre once, but then he's going to get completely murked. Although I don't know what the self-mutilation is. Okay, so self-mutilation, our pyre takes 3 damage if we don't purge it, which is fine. We can take... I mean, he only deals 3 damage, so it doesn't really matter that much. I don't want these two attacking my pyre, though. Yeah, so both of these two are going to get through. So because of Relentless, this combat continues until there's nothing left. So now this floor is frozen and we can no longer do anything down here. Take him out. Put this train steward here, and then we will purge self-mutilation so we don't take 3 guaranteed damage on our pyre. And then he's going to lose 2. He's going to lose 10 HP because our train steward is going to be able to attack twice. 1, 2. Okay, now we have 2 train stewards here. And yes, the order of once you position your units on the floor does matter which one gets taken out first. Obviously, since they're both the same, doesn't really matter. Let's get rid of this self-mutilation. And as you see here, the clergyman is dead. Big time plays there, train steward. Good job. And yeah, there you go. That's one battle here in Monster Train. And you see here, after we're done, we get a bit of gold. We get some card packs here. Allied Clan Pack means that's the other faction that we unlocked at the start here that we chose for the Hellhounds. So, good. We got a 1-turn boss rush, 10%. Let's go. Deal 10 damage to the front enemy unit for 0 cost. Deal 2 damage and move that unit to the front. Or Wildwood Sap, apply 5 regen. Restores 1 health per stack at the end of each turn, decreases each turn. I like the idea of just having offense, so let's go for Sting. Alright, now we have a unit card here, the Fledgling Imp. Apply 3 rage to friendly units. Unfortunately, we don't have anything that attacks yet, Fledgling Imp. Well, I guess that's not true. We do have the Trained Stewards, which is the neutral faction. That doesn't sound too bad, actually. Vent is an AoE, but I don't like X-cost cards unless we have some sort of synergy. Let's go for the Fledgling Imp. It only costs 1 capacity, so might as well. All right, here's the choices as we go to the Cliffs of Fallen Souls. Merchant of Steel, forge units to gain new powers. Awoken Banner, gain an Awoken unit, which is a special type of unit. Merchant of Magic, it forge our spells to gain new powers. And then a Hellhorn Banner, gain a Hellhorn unit. Let's go for the Awoken units. All right, so there is our Uncle Deckard of the game. Upgrade a unit with 3 combat and 3 attack and 5 HP. We got 200 gold right now, large stone. Upgrade a unit with plus 1 capacity, plus 10 damage, and plus 10 HP. Yo, what if, though? What if we put that... Oh, we can't. I was hoping I could put that on the Sentinel. But I guess we can't do that. That still sounds fantastic, though. Or... We could put that on the Train Steward. Yeah, let's give that to a Train Steward. There we go. And then we can re-roll this if we want to. We can leave our re-rolls behind, because if your re-rolls don't re-roll, then you're no re-roll of mine. And we might as well just go all the way here. So these are the upgrade slots that we've got. And then let's upgrade you. Sure. Now, obviously, I could have purged a card here, and I could have re-rolled the shot, but I can do that. Let's see what our Awoken unit is. We have the Animus of Speed, Multi-Strike 2, so that's pretty good. Or the Wiltwood Sapling, so this is an epic card, as you see here. Or ultra-rare, or super-rare. Well, whatever, it's an epic card. Wilting Sapwood, Revenge, gain 1 damage, triggers 1 damage. Oh, wait, no, I take that back. Revenge, we gain 1 Ember when it takes damage. Yo, that might be incredible. Let's go for that. Barb Disciple, these spike foes make direct attacks more painful. Using spells from afar will let you fight without sacrificing units. Non-boss enemy units get plus 4 attack. We get an additional unit draft. Nah, I don't think we need that. I do actually want to try to win one. All right, well, I think that honestly, we got a good play here. We have a really strong first floor. So what we can do is we can put the Wilting Sapwood. We'll put the Wilting Sapwood first, and then the Sentient behind it. And then we can just flat out just take down this one with the Rejuvenate. Except he had armor. So she's going to get passed. Oh, wow. She gave the collector spikes. What a jerk. Use a Train Steward up here. Wow, having this Wilting Sapwood super good, getting all that ember. There we go. All right, the boss is coming up next, and we're just absolutely destroying right now. And let's set us up the... Let's get our Uber Steward up here. Actually, no, we can't. Well, then we'll leave the Uber Steward up at top. Yeah, the last stop. Look at him. Look how Uber he is. He's so large.
My new Luifu.
All right, so unfortunately, we don't have any capacity down here for the Fledgling Imp, but we can give Rage to these two to make them super beefy. I got an achievement that says Simple, with Imp being in the middle. We can deal 10 damage now for the Sting, and I like the sound of that. Remember, we can also spam Heal on the Sentient with Rejuvenate to deal even more damage here. So let's go Sting. And then we go Heal. Well, actually, we can use all of this. Get rid of you. And then heal. Heal. We're still going to lose these two, but that's okay. This dude has no prayer of getting past the next floor. So I'm going to speed up combat here. Look how much ember we're gaining. We've got 11 ember. We have 11 Ember. Yeah. I think that we're going to be okay on this run. Well, at least on this fight anyway. And I guess I'll just use some of my 11 Ember. Wow, that rage really, really packs a punch. Look at that. Two-turn boss rush. I'll take it. We got a clan pack, an allied clan pack. Awesome. Let's see. Steel Enhancer, Pyre Shards. Enhance a unit with plus 3 attack and plus 3 HP. I kind of like that. I like the idea of enhancers. Apply 6 rage. Wow. That's 12 damage. Piercing. Damage dealt by this card ignores armor and shield or fortify. Dude. Well, it costs 3 Ember, though. I think we can skip this one. Let's skip it. As you saw there, we gain a little bit of monetary value if we skip a card. So we're at 120 gold. Hell Vent is duplicate. Pyre Remains restore 30 pyre health. We don't really need that, so it's kind of a waste, I think. Although duplicating a card would be kind of nice. We can you know what? We can actually duplicate the sapwood, and I think that's a good idea. Let's duplicate the wilting sapwood. Yeah, that card is a beast. Yeah, that didn't matter. Then we have the caverns here. So this is going to be a random chance event that you can get early on. A fissure in the ice forces the bone shaker to stop. The bone shaker is the train, by the way. You've seen cracks like this before, often allowing you to multiply your forces through some ancient magic, but this one is different. Unstable. Throwing something into the fissure could have unusual side effects, while just absorbing the energy from afar could have a more expected effect. So you get something that could greatly benefit you, but with a risk, or you could just go for an easier to expect outcome, which is what I'm going to do. And I think that we should copy Sting. Even from a safe distance, the energy is almost too strong to endure, but it has the intended consequence of duplicating your forces. Awesome. All right. All right, so we have Daedalus here. Heaven's disgraced professor has improved his explosive inventions, creating protection through technological advancements. Double barrel, constructed twice. So his bombs are going to explode twice if we don't take him out. Okay, that's bad. Because those bombs do a lot of damage. I think they draw random effects, but I could be wrong about that. The music for this fight is incredible, by the way. Okay, so he has moved up here. So I'm going to just say no. So the Daedalus boss, basically, he can go into any floor no matter what. And there's nothing that you can really do about him. Gonna put the sentient down here. And I think that she's just dead, but we can at least take out two of them. Well, she's not dead, but... Okay, so there's the explosion. It's a shame that we didn't draw a heal. Let's deal 10 damage to the front enemy. Steward. Imp. For the rage. Steel Enhance. He's gonna take how much damage? Oh yeah, we have to take the bomb out first. Okay, yeah, then they all live. Okay. And let's put the steel enhancement on the sentient. So two of them will die, this one won't. Okay, the bomb's on the second floor now. Finally we get the sapwood. Honestly, I think we put the sapwood up here. We have to take out this bomb, otherwise it's going to deal massive amounts of damage. We don't lose anything down here, but they don't lose anything up there either. Let's take that out, and then we're going to gain a bunch of ember here. But they are going to get one hit on our pyre, but that's okay. Yeah, our pyre does that beefed up damage here, so that's good. Okay, Daedalus went up top. That's not good, especially since we didn't draw a torch. Okay, wilting sapwood we can put up here. We can heal this one. We can't do anything about that bomb. We can take down pretty much everything in here. We're going to lose this. We're going to lose the steward, but that's okay. Excuse me. Yeah, Rejuvenate's doing work here. And then if we put the steward, that's a super steward. All right, regular steward we can put behind the wilting sapwood. And then the super steward we can't put anywhere, which kind of sucks. Yeah, we can't place anything up here. Okay, so we're going to basically take down that, and the bomb's going to get through, which kind of stinks. Wow, this is a long wave. Daedalus still isn't even down yet. But we have 7 ember now, thanks to the wilting sapwoods. Okay, so we can double sting. Yeah, let's sting this and then heal. And then that's dead. The torch. I mean, everything's down right now, so. And I don't mind if this hits this, although that would give us ember, but let's just keep everything healthy. Down she goes. All right, so we got our hits on Daedalus there. Wow, that's some pretty awful draws. Well, we can deal 20 damage to him right now thanks to Rejuvenate. And then I guess we'll just torch him. Alright, down to 159. Steel Enhance is real good. We have the Super Steward as well. Yeah, I wish I could remove him. But Steel Enhance this one. Well, let's see. 30. Okay, yeah. Let's go for Steel Enhancer. Heal him up. Man, I wish I could put the Super Steward in. So we're going to deal 44 damage to him. All right. We got to get him to... We deal 35 damage. I mean, it's not ideal that we're not getting very much help here with the spells, but... We can try to heal up. He deals 9 damage. If we heal him up to 15, he's still going to get just 2 attacks anyway. So there's no reason to heal. But we also have like tons of ember, so it doesn't really matter what we do here. But the pyre is going to finish him off after 3 attacks. Okay. So we got past Daedalus, but we did lose a lot of HP on our pyre. So that was our first major victory that we got. We got major enhancements, a rare pack, and a unit draft, as well as 100 gold. Okay, let's see here. We got Fel's Remorse, so we gain 1 ember per turn. Light of Seraph, we get 1 card per turn. Or Herzal's Compound, we gain 1 capacity on every floor. And your pyre gets plus 10 attack and 30 HP. I think I'm going to go for Herzl's Compound. I like having the capacity. All right, we get a rare pack. Let's see. Spike of the Hellhorn. Apply 2 Rage, 2x Armor. Wadwood Tome. Apply Quick. Attacks before enemy units during combat. That's pretty good. Channel Song. Draw a unit, enhance it with plus 20 attack, plus 20 HP, and a 0 cost. That could be incredible. I kind of like the randomness of that. Let's go. Let's do it. That could single-handedly win some fights for us. We got to go multi-strike. I love multi-strike. Animus of Speed. Yeah. So, but I mean, but basically what you're seeing here is the overall premise of Monster Train. It's very, very good and a lot of fun. It's very easy to understand once you see things and how they move, like any game, really. So you can see our up here. These are our artifacts we got. We definitely want to heal our Pyre, so we should go over here regardless of what's over here. We get coins, we get Pyre health, and a Merchant of Magic. Upgrade a spell with plus 5 magical power. We can reduce the Ember cost of one card or spell. Eternal Stone. Upgrade a spell to remove, consume, and cost plus 1. Hang on a second, coach. We can remove, consume? Yeah, that seems incredible. We get a free unit every time we play Channel Song, and we can now play it without having to worry about it being consumed. That seems incredible. That seems really incredible. And then we can lower it back down to 1. Dude. Did we just make a big-time play? I think we just made a big-time play. Uncle Deckard hooking us up. Heal up the Pyre. And then, yeah. I think we just made an incredible synergy. Protectors of the Clipped. Don't get clapped now. Giant Slabs of Stone. Blah, 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 blah. Enemy units enter with 10 armor. Additional 100 coins. Eh. We're gonna pansy out of a lot of the early trials here, because I actually want to try to get a win. I can't let Ryan get a win if I don't get a win. Even though I don't know if he's won yet. Well, I mean, okay. Channel Song is pretty ridiculous. Yeah. Let's go for Animus of Speed behind. And then Fledgling Imp. And the Animus of Speed is going to absolutely obliterate everything. I mean, why do we have this? Did we just draw an extra card or something? Well, I'll just put it. Yeah. Incant. Gain 10 armor. Well, you're still dead. Yeah. All right, we got a collector up here. Go ahead and grab that real quick. Actually, let's not put a train steward up there, because I don't know if I'm going to want that capacity. Whoa, hang on a second. He's got 3 HP. Never mind. Okay. So, yeah. So, like, both of you are still completely and utterly, like, destroyed. Fifteen damage there. Yeah, the Animus' speed is just so good. Steel Enhancer, yeah, put that on the Animus, please. Thank you. This is not our Super Steward, so I'm not going to worry about that. The Incant did nothing. We just take him out. And could put a steward up here, but I kind of want to save that capacity spot for the wildwood sapling. Okay, there's our sapling. There we go. Yeah, we get respite here. And we can put another Wildwood Sapling here. Sorry, Wilting Wood Sapling. All right, here comes the boss. Man, that Animus is just destroying people. Okay, Slay. Add the Ultimate Penance card to the top of your draw pile after he kills something. So, okay, we got our Super Steward here. See if we can yes, we can get one more hit. No, we can't. He's gonna attack twice and kill this anyway. It doesn't matter if we heal this unit. Okay, so this is all we got. Unfortunately, again, we didn't get our Super Steward out, so it doesn't really matter what we do here. All right, let him have it, team. Wow, he gave us three of these. Well, I guess screw me then, right, game? All right, thank God we have the wilting sapwoods. Let's enhance you a little bit, so he's gonna have to attack this four times instead of three. And you see how much more damage they take just from us keeping the simple act of us keeping an enemy or a unit alive. And then he only gets two attacks and the pyre will take him out. Oh boy. All right, preserve thorns, add three sting to your hand. Oh, to your hand. That's really good. That's 30 damage. Dude, I like the sound of that. Give me that. Impolate. Deal damage to a front enemy unit equal to 20 times the number of imp units in your deck. Inflame. Apply two rage and 5 armor. Fire Chomper. Another imp. Summon. You gain 5 ember. Sure. Anything that can give us ramp like that, sure, I'll take it. All right, again, we can restore HP on our pyre. I don't see any other reason not to do that. We could get an artifact, but I think that keeping our pyre healthy is good. There we go. Merchant of Trinkets. Rage does not decay on friendly units. Dude. Absolutely. Select and remove up to 2 cards from your deck. Okay. But I don't think we need as many torches. Because the heal gives us more benefit from us being able to heal the Sentinel, whatever it is. Alright. Upgrade your champion. So now we deal 20 damage when we heal. Or we draw one whenever it gets damaged. I like the idea of dealing 20 damage. That seems really good. So we got a beefed up... We have a beefed up Sentinel now. The Sycophants of Seraph. Seraph has recruited many to his cause with Winged and Clipped. These followers have grouped together and inundate you with sheer numbers. They get plus 6 attack. Nah. All right, extinguish. Give plus 2 to all other friendly units. Let's get our sapwood down there immediately. Let's do that, and put you up here. She's so good, dude. She's so good. All right, preserves thorns. Let's just do that real quick. Just take that. There we go. All right. Oh no, I meant to put that on her. Whatever. Wow, that guy's beefy. This gives us five pyre, or five ember, I mean. This guy's super beef. We don't have our. He won't. Our train steward won't die if I put him in front of the sentient. I can put the pyre chomper down here. I mean, we might as well. And then I don't want to kill these guys yet because I don't want to buff. I don't want to buff their beefy guy. Good job, Fire Chomper. Okay, there's our Super Steward. Definitely need to put him there. Heal you to kill basically all of them. Pyre took a little bit of damage. All right, finally we get Channel Song. That's what I was waiting for. Oh my god, we got a Wilting Sapwood that does 25 damage and has 50 HP. Holy smokes, coach. Yeah, that's pretty good. Unfortunately, we don't have any capacity down here. So let's put it on these guys. Oh wait, nah, we don't have any capacity. All right, well, we'll put it there. Okay, so let's get rid of you. Merc you. And then the final train steward we can't do anything with. Now remember, our rage doesn't go down. Stealth 5. Not a target for combat in the next 5 turns. What? How are we supposed to stop him then? So he's gonna gain 4 H. He's gonna gain 4 damage from this, I guess. I don't understand how we're supposed to deal damage to him though. So what the heck? He's got 300 HP. What are we supposed to do about this? I guess this. I guess it's all for spells. Okay. Well, now he's going up against our beefiest line, and we just top decked Channel Song, although it's not going to matter. Yeah, we can't do anything with that. Well, our Sapwood's going to live, and he's only going to have... He'll have 31 HP, so he only gets one attack on our Pyre. That's fine. Yeah, he only gets one attack and then he's done. All right. Not too bad. This is definitely the furthest I've gotten so far. Focus growth. Restore 20 health. Draw 1. Apply rooted 1 to an enemy unit. Draw 1. But rooted means they cannot move. Bosses are immune. Honestly, I like Preserve Thorns. I like the idea of having costs, zero cost cards. Important work. Sacrifice an imp, gain 5, draw 1. Impolate, Deal damage to the front enemy equal to 20 times the number of imps that you have in your deck. Or branding right. Piercing, deal 5 damage, apply 20 armor. I mean, a free card draw seems good, but we have to sacrifice an imp, which is fine, I guess. Yeah, 40 damage is a lot. I'll probably just go for important work. I like the idea of gaining Ember for moves. From units that are already, like, already on the field. Okay. No Pyre heal this time. We've got Hellbent, Unstable Vortex, Merchant of Trinkets, and an Artifact. Let's go for... There's a Concealed Caverns here, too. Let's go for that. Who is this? The historian makes his way towards the train in his unusual carriage.
Hellborn! How fortunate am I that our travels have finally crossed paths. I'm recording the events of the Armageddon for posterity. Possibly futile, I know. But I shall make a fortune if you do somehow succeed.
But how would you characterize yourself? Honest, aggressive, or stealthy? Definitely honest. Purge. Oh, okay. Aggressive. Your pyre gets plus one attack for every five coin you have. Stealthy. Deal 2 damage to enemy units, slay, getting 50 coin. For every 5, so that's basically 41 damage. Seems pretty good.
Ah, yes, fabled fighting spirit of Hellborn. I'll expect nothing less. Your account shall make for wonderful reading.
Here's some assistance. Yeah, so our pyre now does 86 damage. I don't know how much you're supposed to let your pyre fight in this game, but it seems like it does quite a bit of fighting. Let's get rid of our basic stewards. We don't need them. There we go. Going for kind of a thin deck daddy here. When you play your third card of a turn, draw 3. Apply Rooted to an enemy units when they enter a floor below the pyre room. So that's the third floor. First Hellbank. Exiles cards get plus 3 to. I'm not a fan of any of these really. Although Rooted does seem kind of nice. We could also go for another remove. We could just reroll. Let's reroll. Enemies get minus 1. Tempered Talisman, Thorn Fruit. Plus 3 magic power is pretty good. Minus 1 attack also seems brilliant. Anytime that we can lower the enemy's attack, I'm going to do that. All right, here we go. Fell Wings of Light. Alabaster Guardians now have multi-strike, fell powers, and rage units. And use with rage. Alabaster Guardians. Immobile, they have 60 HP. Okay, we cannot afford to buff the wrong unit for the speed animus. What? This dude's got 700 HP? Are you kidding me? Nice. I guess there's no reason for us not to play the Pyre Chomper. Meep. Yeah, so he just buffed it and gave it a whole lot of everything. But luckily we just got a whole bunch of restores, so... I guess, see you later, dude. Alright. Oh, I don't have enough Ember. That's okay. No, our imp. Our fat imp. He was one day from retirement. All right. I can sacrifice that imp. Thank you. Oh man, we got Steel Enhancer too. Heck yes. That's a heckin' yes for me. Look at the sapwood here. Put this train steward in front here. There's our Ember. So they got one hit on the Pyre. All right, let's go over Channel Song. Excuse me? You seem to be forgetting something, game. I seem to remember using Channel Song. I seem to recall using Channel Song. Unless this guy absorbs the... Unless Encant absorbs the spell like a counter spell? I don't know. I'm a little bit confused on that one. All right, let's get our Super Steward out. Super Steward up here, up top. I guess we don't have any units in our draw pile is the only thing I can think of. But he's still dead no matter what. Okay. I do not want to lose our Super Steward. These things are dead no matter what. Heal up. Well, I mean, this thing's dead no matter what. Get out of here. Okay, then we can heal. Definitely want to get the Steel Enhancer out here. Then we can heal them up. We might as well. We don't have any more imps, unfortunately. We can almost take care of this one here. Do that. Do that. He's going to take a lot of damage down here. And he took 45 damage there. Wow, look at all the stings we have. Okay. All right. And again, we don't have any creatures left, so there's no need for Channel Song now, which kind of stinks. So he does 16 damage. Or she does. I didn't realize it was a chick. Good damage there. We need to get him above 16. Or actually him above 16 as well. 404 HP, good lord. I don't know about this one, team. I don't know what I could have done differently on that. It's unfortunate that Channel Song, man, that was a good deck too. Oh, we got so close. Hey, we got a new card. Apply 2 regen, 2 spikes, add a copy of this card to the discard pile. Hell yeah. Gnarled Root, gain +1 stack spikes each time it's applied. Hell yeah. All right, well anyway, March of Shields, move a unit to front, apply 15 armor. Ashes of the Fallen, summon abilities trigger an additional time. Yo, that's actually incredible. You beat your friend. I beat Ryan. Take that, you freaking egg. I wish I could have, like, seen that. Let's see. Ziggy D beat me on that. Wins. Ziggy D has 8? What the heck? Oh, yeah, well... Well, I beat Ryan on that one. Yeah, take that, you freaking egg. Anyway, that's going to be it. Thank you very much, everyone. I do appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video and you wanted to see more of Monster Train, definitely let me know by clicking the like button and leaving a comment down below. Again, the game you can play right now for free with the demo on Steam. It releases on the 21st of May. And again, thank you very much to the developers for providing me with this press key. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.